in the precious name.
Bless your birth. Hallelujah.
Yeshua HaMashiach. That Almighty Yahweh grants us this day again. We may come into His presence to delight in the abundance of His, not only His Oshia, the riches of His plenty, His abundance, His life, but also His Ashia, that we delight with the abundance of His Shalom to cause us to be happy. The song says, I sing because I'm happy. I sing because I am Yafash. I'm free. And so when one is not free from their own bondage, of their own sin and wickedness, you cannot come before the Abba with filthy, vile, yacht, hands that are filthy and full of stench. You cannot offer up Zabacha, the offering that is acceptable. We as a nation of people, we better get in a hurry, for the sun is going down. It's getting late in the evening. Oh Yahweh, it is very late in the evening. The son of Sadiq, the son of Sadiq. Now we don't hear the power of His Hamashiach. We're drinking from a dispenser of every kind of damn corrupt ideology and sinful practices of man, from a mind that is so damnable, convoluted, and filthy that we don't even know when the power of the son of Sadiq, the righteous one of Yah, when the power of that revelation is expressed unto us, because we have polluted ourselves. He raised up children and they rebel against Him. For some reason, in our self-imposed grandizing status of who we are and what I am, we tend to negate the excellence of our Abba. Not me. You are a damn liar. There's not one sin that we are not guilty of. This arrogant generation thinks that that's for you. No, that's for you, my friend, that have joined us via the live stream, audio and visual. He spoke to a nation. This nation is wicked. It's a sottish people. As stupidly dumb we are. For some reason, you think you're smart, you silly little boy. We greet you all in your Yeshua's mighty name, in the excellence of the power of Yah, that He caused the birth of His Torah to be conceived within this Yeshua, this woman of His elect. That's what we are. And it was manifest in the most excellence of His power. That there was nothing the world could charge Him with. No sin, no wickedness, for His record is spotless. Well, I don't believe that. Well, that's why the wicked ones don't believe that He created all things. If He created man out of the dust of the earth, He certainly can bring forth, as He has, a living Torah. Yeshua is that living Torah. I was out yesterday. I want to read this verse I'm going to teach today. My mind, as it always pondered the excellence of Torah and the beauty, as I was preparing some of the seed trees into the yard that my seeds came in today, I need to get it done. That's why we don't despise the toilsome labor and the husbandry and farm. For Yah made that for man. That's why we're in the condition that we're in. Give me some hard labor. I don't run from hard labor. I'm not afraid of it. Not at all. Not at all. And as I was laboring on yesterday, as the old Kherushim would say, I could not think but of his tremendous chassid, his mercies, his racham, his tender kindness of his mercies toward me. Wretched thing, of no value at all, no significant value at all. And as I began to ponder all of the elements around me, I thought of this verse here. I want to read it. I want you to hear this. David said, I will praise, I will yada, I will load or esteem ya with a voice of praise that is beyond my ability, my natural state of man to contain it. We will sing the song, yada, 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 yada. Yada ya for Yahshua HaMashiach. Oh, yada ya, yada ya. Yada ya for Yahshua HaMashiach. And I'm Barach Yahweh. All that he has done for me in Yahshua. Oh, I'm Barach Yahweh. Oh, he has done for me. So David used the expression of not hallel. He says, I shall yada, I shall praise you, I shall loud with an extreme effort of energy. He said, I shall praise you, Almighty Yah. Why? He says, I shall praise you, first of all, for I am Yira, I am fearfully. There is a reverence of all of your magnificence, your power, your creation. He said, I am fearfully. Yeah? And he uses the word Pala, I am wonderfully. That's what he said. Fearful to reverence Yah. And Pala, it is beyond the concept of the analogy of man to create a linguistic of words to describe the beauty of Yah's wonderful composition of you, how he made us. He says, I am Pala, I am so distinct by the markings of Yahshua HaMashiach, I am separated from the masses of the nation. That is the Pala of Yah. He has made me with such distinction. We are an ignorant people. We are ignorant as they come. He says to Yah, I marvel at your work, at your asa. What you have done, what you have fashioned and made with your hand. He says, it's beyond my concept to understand. And he says, above all that, my nephesh, the life of whom I am, he says, knows Yada quite well. very well who you are. And so he created the great creation that we marvel, even when we look at each other and see the magnificent wonders of Yah. The reason I pondered upon that is because what I think of my inabilities, but his great abilities. When you ponder the fact, I want to ask you a question. Out of your uzen, out of your eye and your eyes, your natural eyes, how far can you see physically? If you go to the waters of the ocean, and you look out where the horizon meets the water, that's minimum 25 miles. So how far you think you can see? You think you can see 100 miles? You think you can? Who think that they can see 200 miles with their eyes? Who think they can't see 500 miles? Can I get a show of hands that can see 500 miles? You that are listening by via the live visual broadcast, email me and let me know you can see 500 miles. As I am putting dirt in the trays, and the excellence of his beauty that emanates around, as I could hear, I know spring is upon us because there's a certain sound in the air. I hear it's coming. And the toilsome labor, the husbandry, the farm to work. And I ponder that, can I see 500 miles? I can not only see 500 miles, I can see 500,000 miles. I can look at the distance of 1,000,000 miles, 10 million. How is that, man? We take the scientific approach as a young lad. It's one thing I learned in school, that the distance of the sun from the earth is 93 million miles. And as I looked upon that thing yesterday, I said, oh yeah, how marvelous and how magnificent have you made man. And beyond that is infinity. How far can you see? We're an ignorant people. We don't want to be taught. I learned that in the 6th, 7th grade, I believe, in my segregated environment, that the sun is 93 million miles from the face of the earth. And he gave me vision to see 93 million miles. If that is accurate, you say what you want to. Or it's look close, but no, it's 93 million miles. We're always trying to suppress things according to our limitation of knowledge. That's why we're dumb. We need the mind of Yeshua HaMashiach. That's what we need. So I know I can see minimum 93 million miles. When we look at the distant stars, they declare that they're farther than that. And look at how marvelously we are made. We are so damn self-conceited and wicked. We don't even think on those plateaus. We're so lustful and consumed with our own perverse matter of life. We look dumb and we act dumb. And I'm not afraid to say it. We are a pala people. We are a distinguished people. We have been marvelously made. We're not some jackasses in the wild that look and act like some feeble beast that doesn't even know where the master stable is that they can eat, refresh themselves. But we don't look at me that way, but you look at me that way. We don't look at me, myself, and I that way, but we look at you, yours, and all that you possess. It is the truth, O woman. We have this convoluted perspective of us. Me, not Yisrael, but me. You're going to hell. And I frankly don't give a damn whether you buy it or not. You buy every lie. You buy every falsehood. Every shekha. You buy the deception of your own mind. No man has deceived you. You've deceived your own damn wicked self. It's your heart that is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Will I try things by the spirit of your damn wicked mind? You're not going to try me that way. There's only one way that the nations of the earth and Hashatan knows the people of Yah. There's only one way that we are manifest and made known by one thing. That we do not transgress the Torah, we do not sin with a willful act against Almighty Yah. Not because you smile like a damn monkey all day, you grinning and skinning. Because you think you're sweet and kind. And then they will know that you love Yah and his children because you keep the mitzvah, the commands, what he has saved unto Yisrael. There's a difference between the children of the devil and the children of Yah. They're children of light and children of darkness, and we see the nature of the children of darkness rising up. They love to kill and destroy. Destroy the earth. I'm going to teach in a moment. As I said, I was talking to my precious Aunt Frank and his Diana there, his Ishaw in Nebo, West Virginia. And he says to me, Reach, I want to tell you, I love the honesty of a man. He said, where I live, we are among what you would call flat out hillbillies, simply rednecks. I have no problems with hillbillies or rednecks. I can handle them. He says, that's the environment. Yet that has not produced this antagonistic, anti-Yaruach in this man. He says to me, from the first day I heard you, he said, I knew that this man was real. His grammar, his speech is slow. He takes his time in his delivery. And I said, we're coming to see you, my Ach Mikaya. I see you in the house. If I can see 93 million miles, I can see you in Cincinnati, all right? Well, you're making boastful injectors of you. No. Why is it that we can't appreciate Almighty Yah? You think you're the most beautiful woman? You think you're prettier than all women? Stop it. You think you're the most virile, the most strongest of men? Stop that. But that's the ignorance of a nation, a blinded people. People with no idea, no spiritual or sensual knowledge of intellectualism. I'm not trying to reason in the intellect of the world. I don't want to reason in their spheres. I want to know what truth says. Because I must get right. There's a day that life shall cease. And you can continue to act like a budding damn jackass of a fool. You're going to find yourself segregated from Yah. And that's a fact. He that is often reproved, there is nothing more damaging and devastating, as Yah would use the word shomim, when he eviscerate, destroy, bring down, not even to the powders of the dust of the earth. There's nothing more that ignites Yah with a tremendous destruction. It's when a man, when one of Yisra'iyah is often reproved, and they harden, they stiffen their neck. And then Yah says, then suddenly, or destruction, shomeim, suddenly comes. And that is without warning. That's without the nacha, the sound of the shofar. And we stiffen our necks and our hearts. That's why they killed Sophonia, Stephen, to Zephaniah. But he told them, you stiff-necked and you uncircumcised. There is no brits milah. There is no mul. You got the fat of your wickedness surrounding that fat heart of yours, your lover. Yeah. You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in your leg. Why do you always resist? He did not say sometimes. He said you always resist Ruach HaKodesh, the spirit of Yah's truth. And that's the way we do it, Yisra'iyah. I'm not here to cut corners. And I'm not here to give you a cake that is baked or something that is store-bought. I don't want that kind of a cake. Make the cinnamon rolls the old-fashioned way. Bake me a cake that way. It's empty. It's fluffy. And we love superficial things. I speak to Beit Yisra'iyah. Whole. W-H-O-L-E. Whole food. I speak the whole. The whole. Fullness. The substance. The abundance. To all Yisra'iyah. And we don't identify who not I am. You better identify who you are. And if you know who you are, you will know who I am. They didn't know who they were. That's why they didn't know Yahshua HaMashiach. You identify what truth is in you, then you will know when truth is spoken. We've been trained by an oppressive mindset, spirit of slavery and whoredom. Not only in a physical, biological sense, but also in a spiritual realm. We serve our emotions, our feelings, and our attitude. We take great pride in who we are. I'm stronger than he. I'm stronger than she. And what a wickedness. You have nothing. We're full of sin. David said, in sin did my mother conceive me. And he used the words avon, avin. And in iniquity did she shape, form my mind. Yah did not make you that way. He made us one way. I don't give a damn what you say. He made us one way. In the image of he. That's the only way he made you. No other way, Yisra'iyah. I'm going to teach you. Yeah, I'm going to cry aloud and spare not. I want to close in this teaching on the holocaust of this hour. This Yeshua, this offering that must be. And can I inject something before I proceed? You got individuals that will say, you cannot keep the Mo'adim, you cannot keep Pesach outside of Yerushalayim, the city where Yah has put his name, the house where he ordained. And I show you the subtlety of the darkness of the mindset of men, how stupid we are. We think we know, and we analyze things according to our ignorance, our unlearned ability. It's one thing that Evangelist Hertzfeld taught me, son, pay careful attention to each word. We try to do this compilation with all words to mean one thing and combine them without a distinct marking of value of each word. That's what we have done. And there is one key word in that whole writing in Devarim. Yah says this, only one thing. He says that Yisrael, you cannot sacrifice Zebach to offer up the blood atonement on Pesach outside of Yerushalayim. And when the city of Yah is renewed, we go to offer up the offerings unto Yah, and it will not be this spit literature of what we call praising Yah. It will be a voice that is resound and powerful. He did not say don't keep the Pesach. He said you cannot offer. You cannot offer. You cannot offer. You cannot offer the Zabach. That's what it said. The sacrifice. Because Yeshua was offered up for Yisrael. And so you cannot offer it up. To show you the dynamics of one word and how we as a nation miss it. Because everyone wants to be smarter than everyone. You be smart. Yeah, I use that broken grammatics. You be smart. I will be ignorant. You understand? I will allow you to be smart. And then I will learn from the ach that speak to me, their actions, their ways, their chutz, their beauty. I'll let you be the smart one. How about that? Is that all right? That's why we're going to judge by, be judged by every word, are we not? It's life and death and the power of the tongue. That's why we got to be quick to hear and slow to speak. We, our ways are made known to us, our first response, well, I'm not that way. But yet you see me that way. You see your heart that way. You judge me with the same spirit as you judge others, but you don't judge yourself that way. You're a wicked man. I don't care who you are. And then you do things that are worse than what I do. He's going to burn this whole house to the ground. That's why judgment must begin. If judgment began first at Beit Yisrael, what shall be the kates, the ultimate end of the massive destruction? What shall be the kates, the end of those that do wickedly and live unrighteously? What shall be the end? You got plenty of false pretenders. They talk with their damn mouths, but their hearts are far from it. Oh, I love y'all, you damn liar. He's given us opportunity, hasn't he? So let us do tov unto all men, especially preference the house of Yisrael. You can love your wicked grandmammon, your wicked pappy, and your hoe of a daughter, and your damn fag of a son. You can't love Yisrael, go to hell. Damn you. You segregate from them. Hallelujah. You might as well appreciate me because I'm going to preach. I'm not afraid of the faces of the people. It's not enough money here for me to be afraid of that. I don't have a $1 million house. I have a home that costs $1,500. And over the years, I may have $5,000. That's speaking a lot of money if I got that in it. Because everything is recycled, everything is used. And believe me, everything was bought on the cheap. Hallelujah. So I don't have a Mercedes-Benz or a Lamborghini or a Bentley with the initials RDY in it. I don't have that. I don't have $1,000 alligator shoes and $2,000 suits, $900 belts. There's a place I buy my belts and I can find them on the cheap. And I like cheap material too. So there is nothing for me to gain as far as things. This is a dumb world. Who sing that song, this is a mean old world to have to live in. Sam Cooke, all by yourself. This is a mean old world to have to live in. All by yourself. Whoa. It is a mean, mama knows that one. I can't sing it, I have the song. But it's a mean old world to have to live in all by yourself. That's why he wants Yisrael to learn how to have a great affinity for each other. And stop being so easily offended, little boy, little girl. Grow up and stop acting like a Nachal or a Leal, a little boy or a Taf. All right? I want to begin. I want to define this word Holocaust again as I'm going to come to the closure on this teaching. I want to move on. On next week, back to no man can buy and sell, and the tribe of Dani, the Danites. This one that shall rise up out of the midst of Yisrael. We're looking to the vile whore they call the Catholic whorehouse, and that's what the Christians do. And all of the signs come from them, but it's not so. The sign of evil came from among Israel. Yes. And you're going to see everything, the anti-Hamashiach, it came from out of the house of Israel. That's why you have a divided house. You have Yehuda. And you have Ephraim. One that thinks that he is superior because he is of a lineage of Yeshua. And one that says, I hold the rights of David, the king of Israel. And that's how we are. We maintain the rights of our wicked ways. David did a wicked thing before Yah. And we maintain that. The Holocaust, the Shoah, the offering that is whole, is complete. That shall be purged by the ush, the fire of Almighty Yah. You cannot bring that which is impure before the offering or the altar of Yah to offer it up. We cannot come with hands that are filthy and dirty. Our hands cannot be unclean. Hands cannot be to me filthy, vile, with every kind of unclean thing that we lay our hands to the plow of every kind of sinful activity. We can't go into the presence of Almighty Yah. And so there must be an offering of the time of the end of the Acharit. And it's going to be tested by the fire as Arzachin Yeremiah has constantly warned us and taught us, repeated to us, reverberated what is in Torah. Because of our own self-conceited activities of our own righteous religious mind, we don't hear. He's given us ears to hear, but we don't hear. They hear not, giving them eyes to see. They see not. So there must be an offering. And so the enemy understanding the very times of Yah, he will seek out to destroy the nation of Yisrael. So he puts it into the hearts of his children to create every form of death. There is no form of death that is more prolific than what this nation creates. The water you drink kills you. The food you go to the store kills you when you buy it. Their medicine kills you. Their drugs kill your sons and their minds to articulate, to think. Their greed and their lust kill you. Their manners kill you. You're laboring day and night on a nickel slavery job and you don't have a damn thing at all. Everything about this nation is death. It kills you. The welfare system kills you. It takes your drive, the very esprit of life from you. That you lay on your ass all day for nickel dime check and some damn food stamps that you can only buy junk with. Yeah. This is a nation of death. Why? Because it was predicated, it was built upon, its dynamic came through the course of death. And it celebrates death. It celebrates killing. And so this is one of the only few nations that have the power not only to kill you, but your children that come after you that are not born, and the ones that come after them that are not born, and the ones that come after them that are not even born. They have the power to do that. Nor the nation of people have that power to do that. She has been raised up by Almighty Yah. She was not raised up by Hashatan. Yah said to Pharaoh, there's only one purpose that I've raised you up. I've made you rich. I have made you powerful. I have made you to be the envious cultures of the world. I've caused your pyramids to rise up, and the dynamics to this day still baffles the mind of man. Yes. I've caused your dynasties to extend beyond the breadth and the height of man. I've raised you up. I brought you forth for one purpose, one reason, one dynamic, that upon you I shall get my chavuts. My honor, I'm going to show you I'm mightier than you. I'm going to show you your mighty chariots of fire. I'm going to bring them down. I am going to quench their fire with the waters of the depths. I'm going to bring them down to the belly of Sheol, darkness of hell. I raise you up. I raise up you, Medio Persian kingdom, the empire. I'll raise you up, the Roman entity, that you were so cruel and so bitter of hatred that everything in your way, you decimated it. You kill, you rob, you stole, you imprisoned, you brought under bondage. I raise you up. I raise you up for one thing, for my children, my people. I will trust. Oh, in Yahweh, I will trust in the Torah of Yah. I will trust in His mitzvah until I die. Oh, I will trust in Yahweh. I will trust. Oh, in Yahweh, I will trust. Oh, in Yahweh, until I die. He said, raise you all up. I raised up this bombastic mentality of America to seek, to kill, to destroy, to manipulate, to bring in some of the most in degraded bondages of all nations of the earth to kill and to destroy. I raise her up that she is pronounced as a super power, that her power is exponentially above all nations, and she has the mentality to burn your babies, to kill your babies, and to kill you. And not only that, I made a pristine Erech, the earth. She has the power to set it on fire. I've given her that. I've granted that unto her. Because upon this Jezebel, I'm going to get honor. I'm going to get the greatest of my honor, for I shall redeem my beards from the four corners of the earth. It is not going to be done by these damn false men that call themselves prophets and the people of God. It's not going to be done by that. It's going to be done by, not by might, nor by your power, but it's going to be done by the living Ruach, the testimony of power in Yeshua HaMashiach. He raised us up. You don't fight against Mr. Barack Hussein Obama. Leave him alone, Israel. You don't fight against the Congress. Let them build the nuclear armaments. Let them build the weapons. Stockpile them. Yah says, I'm going to destroy those that destroy the earth. He's going to kill them. He's going to bring them down to hell. You just don't destroy the earth. You don't become in bondage to her processes and her way of life. Come out of her, my people. Don't be a part of her lifestyle. Don't be a part of her wickedness. Come out of this dirty whore. He raised them all up as he raised Pharaoh to get honor upon him. And he's going to get honor. It's going to be a holocaust. Not like what happened to the Jews, of that people that identify as Jews. When you say that, there are people that get so afraid, as though that is the elect of Yah. People have no problem because their skin is pale. It is the Caucasian skin color. They have no problem with that. But to look at a people whose skin is dark hue and say they're the people of Yah, then the first thing they will say, then you, including race, hell. Everything that you see is based upon race. Everything you see about that book called Torah, they call Bible, Kitveh, it is about race. And for you to say it's not, you are a damn juvenile of a liar. You're full of your own wickedness. You're too fearful to deal with the reality, or you're just plain out damn dumb. And that's a fact. You become all responsive when one speaks like that. I'm not fearful of your damn looks. It is just the truth. It is a fact. And so when you say something about what we call Jews, everyone, oh, we are part of the Judaic Christian religion, not me. Those that call themselves Jews have disdain for those that call themselves Christians. They call them clean nations of heathens, damn fools. And they are the fools. He has a nation that he has hidden in the bosom of Yeshua HaMashiach. And the living Torah, and they're scattered abroad. That's why you denounce the damn white lies and the black lies. But above all, the white lies, because that is the preponderance of strength today. And damn your white Jesus. Your damn black Jesus too. Your Mexican Jesus too. You get all itchy around your ears when you hear me talk, and you get all unnerved because you're full of your damn wickedness. I don't give a damn who you are. I like this man. I really like him. I like him. My son, if it was for money, I certainly would not. I have the articulate ability to speak in a way that I can mesmerize people. I know I can. I can. I can. I know what it takes. I can command their attention, demand it. You look at some of the men that command the attention of people. They could not command my attention. And that's just the truth. Holocaust. Are we at the epic of the greatest of what we call the Holocaust? I want to define this quickly, because you must always advocate the end of all things. You must always revisit the Bereshit, the beginning. You must always. Or the Reshith, the beginning. the introduction of the matter. You must always do that. Holocaust, in its etymology, it has one conclusion. It means this: a burnt sacrifice, a sacrificial offering, just like Elijah, wholly consumed by fire. It must, the dross must come out. The dross, Yisrael. Think it not strange that the fiery trials that shall happen come upon you, as though that this is some strange thing, and where is Yah? Do not think that it is strange. It is not a strange thing, because the offering of the Zebek, the offering, the sacrifice, it must be completely consumed by fire. Zechariah Rabbi has, with the preponderance of Torah, showed us and taught us that when the gold is tried, the dross, the fire, brings out the impurities, and then it is whole and pure. We must understand that the trying of our emunah, our faith, is more precious than that of gold. I will prove it out. There's nothing more precious than the trying of our emunah, our confidence in Yah, the absolute obedience unto our Abba. It is the surety of confidence in what He says. We believe it, it's settled. And we don't need answers or some kind of intellectual deduction from that. We don't see it, but we believe that. There are people that will believe scientific non-evidence, yet they can't believe Yah. We believe that the sun is 93 million miles. When I looked at it yesterday, I say, wow, amazing I am. How wonderfully I am made. How marvelous are these eyes of mine that can see 93 million miles. They will say in my days, that's bad to the bones there, boy. That's bad to the bones. And of course, when I looked at that bad boy up there, I couldn't look long. Whoa, 93 million miles. I know one thing, I can't see 93 million. Nothing else I can see 93 million miles. He says to me, don't overstate yourself, boy. In essence, just don't look on me like you're just looking at the chickens in the field. Yes, sir. 93 million. What is that? You can't even calculate that in your mind. Hallelujah. It also implies a complete or thorough sacrifice or destruction made by fire. He's bringing down your gods. He's bringing down your damn idols, Yisrael. He's going to cause the fire to come down out of Hashemaam. Yes. So the perpetuity of this mental craziness of Hashatan says, I tell you what, I'm going to find every zirah. That's why Yah says, let the wheat and the tear together. And I will send my melachim, the reapers of the harvest, and they shall reap them out. Yeah. Powers of hell say, I'm going to find them out, and I'm going to burn them all. If I have to burn every damn thing up, I'm going to burn. Yah says, it's in your hands. I've raised you up for that purpose, Hashatan. As I did with Eobah, you can do whatever you will to him, but don't touch the ruach. Don't touch his breath. You cannot take his life because you got to come through me. He's not going to let even the most agonizing things take the testimony from us. We got to overcome Yisrael because we love not our lives unto the death. We got to overcome. And that's a fact. So this is the implication of the definitive of the words Holocaust. And so with the convoluted twistedness of the mind of man, they have twisted it. It's not found in the etymology. It's not found in the original writings that this word has any implication as to what we call the Jewish Holocaust. They were not the burnt offerings wholly offered unto Yah. You see a land that is so vile and corrupt, and they have the power to burn the Palestinians. They have the power to burn the Egyptians. They have the power, a little place with around 6 million people in it. They have power. And Saudi Arabia may have the money, but that little piece of land got the nuclear bombs. And so among his children, Hashatan, he has sent forth his fire. He has spread his fire around the nations. He shall cause the fire to come down because Yah will suffer it. A time of famine, great agony. A time of such pollution, Yisrael, you're not the only water we're going to have. We must speak to the rock. We cannot fight against what Yah is causing to come upon us. As they went to Meribeth, and Yah says, speak to the rock, and Hel Moshe smote the rock. You're going to have to stop smiting Yahshua HaMashiach. How you smite your Ach, you smite your Holt, you smite Yisrael. Your damn disdain and your hatred. You're going to have to stop that. You can't continue that way. And they did not speak. We're going to have to speak to the rock. We're going to have to speak to this living well that flows in our bellies. We shall drink of the waters, the Mayim, the waters of life. Yahshua is that living water. He is the water of Hayil. He brings strength and life. He gives us the power of his military back into fight. We are dumb people. You're talking about you. I am a people of Yah. We're ignorant. We're ignorant. That's why we should. How precious are the feet of them that brings, cause it to enter into our bosom. The Bezorach, the teaching of this great message of truth. I assert evangelical hearts feel like a fool because I love what he said. Everything you say rebuked me. That's all I wanted. I didn't want anything that appeased me. Reprove me. Rebuke me. Cut me. Show me me. That has always been my mantra. I don't know about you, but that's what I was. I've never felt like I have arrived. In the most broken of grammatics, when one stands here, I realize how far I am away from Omaria. And Aza, quaint not got time to play around. Aza got to get in a hurry. The sun is setting. Well, that's for him, sure. Feed me, Yah. As David said, until I want no more, just feed me. You don't have to take it. Give it to me. I will eat it all. One more implication or indication of divinity from the etymology dictionary of the words Holocaust. It has nothing to do. It is this word even as it was introduced in the 13th century. It is a sacrifice by fire, burnt offering. It goes through the annals of times through the manipulation of languages to conform, to confit this word to their own dynamics or their own meaning. But its origin is still the same. Yah is Yah, and he is Yah today, and his origin, which is no origin, it is still the same. You can try to alter it, to change it, to try to hibernate it. It's still the same, Yisrael. Yeah. And so that was one, it says the word Holocaust, Nazi genocide of European Jews in World War II. It was first recorded in 1957. I was born before then. It was first recorded in 1957. It tells us in the etymology of this definitive that earlier known in the Hebrew is shu'ah or shu'ah simply implies catastrophic mayhem. The word itself that has no meaning, the word itself was used in the English in reference to Hitler's Jewish policies from 1942. Quote, but not as a proper name for them. Unquote. In essence, it was not a sure. It was mayhem and cataclysmic. But there were nearly 60 million people of the dark hue skin on the Middle Atlantic lost their lives. And there is no language that describes that. It is almost eradicated from the learnings of your children. It has no place in the historical annals at all. And yet they say that there were over a million what is identified as a Jew. This is the subtlety of hell. And this is what Hashatan does, Yisra'yah. That the attention is moved away from the thing that is of relevance and of great point. Not that their lives were not relevant. Yeah. I'm not disputing that. Right. And there are those that will go to the land of Yisra'yah and kiss the dirty wall where the Ruach of Yah is not there. Hallelujah. That city is the city of Sodom and Egypt. Yeah. Faggots run that. One of the largest gay pride movement and days is held right there in the city of Yerushalayim. Nothing but faggots and New York freakers, Russian demagoguery and oligarchy, rich bastards from hell. Has nothing to do with Yah. You can resist it. You can fight against it. I will not fight against it. That was not the Holocaust, the offering that has been ordained by Yah. Eob is the representation of that. He was tried by the fires of hell. I was with your sons, and the fire came down and consumed them all. Holy I. Amleth, the offering was consumed whole. Yet he did not charge you all foolishly. And when this decimation of this wicked earth is coming, I don't care what they try to do to appease our minds and say, well, it's not going to happen. And yet they tell us throughout the annals of their historical billions of your history, yeah? Their billions of your history, that there's always been destructive formations and cataclysmic mayhem to overthrow it and to eradicate all life. That's the bastards and liars that teach your children. When I was a kid, it was 5 million. Now it's untold trillions of years old. It was the Cro-Magnon man and all these different species. Can I say this to you all, Yisra'yah? Listen, we must be wise. You look at all these men that this superficial thing we call science. They come from a monkey. They walk like a monkey. And then all of a sudden, he stands to his feet. I have never seen one, and I've looked. When he stands to his erection, that he looks like any man or any other nationality, people of the dark hue skin. He is always what we call the white man. We are so ignorantly dumb. We don't want to deal with the facts of reality, how the world subtly raped our mind. That's just the truth. It's just the truth. Look, I was just recently looking at the pictures. And the subtlety of that, how it just blinds us. It's always that way. It's just the truth. Why don't we get real and denounce, like one called me and said, you sound like Louis Farrakhan. I said, damn Farrakhan. He didn't like the fact that I said, you need to denounce the lies of this Jesus this devil, this lie, the United States, her wickedness, her corruption. She kills, she destroys, she poisons the rivers, she kills the nations of the people. She does that. But Yah has raised her up. So I applaud her. I don't mess with America. I'm not, don't buy no guns to try to protect yourself. Because when all hell break loose, you got these malicious hell, they're going to turn against each other. You don't need no gun to protect yourself, for we are the Chayil. We have the weaponry of the Ruach of Yah. Your little damn bullet's going to run out. You can buy all the bullets you want to. You can't save yourself that way. You can buy all the high power weapons you want to. You can take a little community here that's 523 square miles of space in Chesterfield. Less than 30,000 people. You got more people in New York City in 5 or 6 apartment buildings. When all hell break loose, let them rally together. And baby, when the fire began to drop, you find this will run to his house, and that will run that way, and that will go there, and that will run that way, and you find them shooting at each other. Don't buy these lies from these liars. Don't buy these lies. There's only one survival. It's in Yahshua HaMashiach. I don't give a damn what your survival skills is, fighting the herbs and the buried heat. It will be nothing but death, Yisrael. It will not be life. You got these liars telling you they're going to teach you a survival institution for what? It's not going to work. Because when the bombs drop, when they drop onto a nation. Let me read a little something, and I want to show you something in Torah, all right? Just give you some kind of idea of the magnitude of this evil consortment of minds of wicked men. Have no counsel of Yah, that their minds are going beyond the limitations that Yah commanded man. Can I read a little bit?
Yes.
May I please? All right, Tota. This article, and I looked through hundreds of pieces, and I look at this all the time. I literally, I studied the effects of nuclear bombs, just like that explosion there in Pripyat, in Fukushima, Japan. It is devastating, as I read to us last week. But this is an article that was written. It is the consequences of using nuclear weapons. I'm not going to read the whole article. It's too large, too long. I want to quote some of the specifics of this article. It was written by Dean Batts and also David Kruger. Quote, "We have yet to fully grasp the monstrous effects of these weapons. The consequences of their use defies all reasons. Transcending, now that's the power, transcending time and space and poisoning the earth and deforming its habitation." What mind thinks of something like that? That's from hell. Deforming the people. Come on. That it evades time. It gives no discernment of time. General Lee Butler, former head of the United States of America Strategic Command, December the 4th, 1996. Quote, "The destructive power of nuclear weapons," I want you to hear this, "the destructive power of nuclear weapons cannot," please hear me, "the force is so pronounced, it cannot be contained, it cannot be contained, it cannot be contained." If something cannot be contained, that means that it extends beyond the boundaries and the borders of any type of measure to prevent it from superseding that. Would that be a clear definition, my heart? It cannot. It cannot be contained in either space breath with that space or time, because it works death for tens of thousands of generations. They have the potential to destroy all civilization and the entire ecosystem of the planet. Now, this is the profound leader of the Nuclear Command Center, a general, and the military elitist of America, that it has the potential to destroy the whole economic or the ecological system, that nothing will grow. What are you going to buy? You notice what he said, that it has the potential to kill and to annihilate all civilization. Hashatam will kill all by the command of Yah. Did he not kill all Eob's children? Did he leave him one? He killed them all. He said, damn it, kill them all. I'm so glad that life and death is in the power of Yah's hand. He said, kill them. Has the potential to destroy everything of an ecosystem, because there's a madness. Because Yah has given a command to a thing called man. And this one that was the covering, Yah says, I'm going to give you opportunity to fight him. And you began here in his leba, in his mind. And so the mind of the corrupt are always inventing. They're inventive. For one thing, death. Tell me what America makes that causes life. All of our medicine kills you. The food that we grow in the fields, they kill you. That's why we cannot despise toilsome labor and husbandry and the farm. They take all the waste of all the plants of the United States, and that's what they're fertilizing your fields with. That's what they're doing. Your bread you eat, your orange juice. That's why he said, you as a nation, you grow some food. Mamas, get up and go to the raised beds and bend your back some, make your back stronger. Come on, daddy, help trim your waistline down, get it stronger. That's just the truth. Don't get offended at me. Don't despise that, before Yah made that for us. To keep that, those old porous, that old filthy stuff in us, pour it out of your skin. Yeah. Don't sit in no air conditioning house. Hell, get hot. Let it sweat. Yeah. Let the sweat roll off your belly. You're not going to die. Yeah. Quote. This is the internal courts of the records of the internal courts of justice, July the 8th, 1996. Quote. The destructive power of today's nuclear weapons is far greater than the weapons that were used at Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Japan. The use of nuclear weapons today could have devastating consequences for humanity and the environment, not only in the country attack, but in neutral countries and in an attack country as well. In essence, the effects of the nuclear fallout, a bomb from Russia on us and a bomb from us on them, it affects Canada and South America and the islands of the sea. And same thing with Russia, the Ukraines, the Baltics, and all of that, Sweden and whole Europe. We're not dealing with some little toy. We're dealing with death, Yisrael. And the enemy says that I will offer a burnt offering unto me. I may have to conclude on next week. Is that all right? Yeah. Wisdom is the principal thing, but in all I get, and we need to understand. We need to have the power to discern. Yeah. It needs to shatter and break down all of our corrupt, wicked ways and our concepts and our thoughts and our analytical approach that is not based upon the Torah. We are some damn dumb people. This is what the Calabria Commission of the Elimination of the Nuclear Weapons and the internal commission of distinguished individuals now that has initiated by the Australian government. In essence, these are the renowned ones that have great knowledge of the nuclear impacts upon nation, people, and the environment. I want you to hear this. They speak, I don't want to read all of this, of the great consequences of just one nuclear bomb. This is the summation of what they said. Hallelujah. It says, we have described the consequences, listen, of using a relative crude nuclear weapon with an explosive force of 1,000 tons, small. It's not huge. That's not, that's something off a Triton submarine that would be launched. We're talking about a crude, that what they call terrorists, getting hold of nuclear contents and building a little crude bomb that maybe goes 100 miles if it goes that far. These bombs are guided by satellites. And once they launch, many of them have the range of 3, 4, 5, 10,000 miles. You don't even see it, just like they don't see the drones. And all of a sudden it just hit. You're not even aware of it. It says, we have described the consequences of using a relative crude nuclear weapon with an explosive force of 1,000 tons. The kind a terrorist might use. And yet America doesn't see that she's a terrorist. She terrorized nations and their babies. She terrorized the environment. But she called those that want to protect their homeland, they are the terrorists. I want to get you first before you get us. A sophisticated nuclear bomb warhead, nuclear warhead, with an explosive force of 100,000 tons, they're between 100 tons and 100,000 tons. The type standard warhead. This is the type standard 100,000 tons. This is just a standard warhead in the American arsenal. Warhead found in the U.S. or British Triton submarine. I told you, what are those Triton submarines? Can settle on the coast of South Carolina and destroy the whole state within minutes. And the fallout will bring death unto all. You understand? This is on a Triton submarine. 1,000. Why so many? 1,000 sophisticated warheads. Listen to the insanity. With 100 million tons of explosive force. How do you measure that? How do you measure 100 million tons of explosive force? That would eviscerate this whole nation here. What kind of mind thinks like that? What kind of mind creates that kind of death? We know that Hashatan was a murderer from the beginning because he didn't abide in truth. He kills, he loves to kill. He's a thief. He comes to steal, kill, and to destroy you, show man. This is what the Cabrera Institution says. In order to illustrate how catastrophic the use of a nuclear bomb can be, we want to give you an example that you can base this on just one small nuclear bomb by terrorists. A rudimentary or a simple built nuclear bomb will have the destructive power equivalent to 1,000 tons, 1 kiloton of 1 kT of conventional high explosive power. According to the Center of Defense Information now, if such a nuclear weapon had been available, listen now, we saw what two planes they said did to the Twin Towers. Now we're talking about a 1,000 nuclear ton weapon. We saw the fallout of death and the diseases of men and the children that are they're suffering today from whatever was in the steel or in the concrete or whatever caused that implosion, whether it was bombs or nuclear phosphorus fuel there. They were sick, the firemen, debilitated because of the dust and all of that. We don't even know the tolls of what has happened to the people. Now, they said two planes did that, right? Listen to this. It says, if such a weapon, just a 1,000-ton nuclear A rudimentary, that's the rudiment that, in essence, we can go to the library or internet and get the ingredients to make one. It said, quote, if such a nuclear weapon had been available to the bombers of the World Trade Center, listen. Not some, not a small portion, but most of Manhattan, Brooklyn, Staten Island would have been eviscerated. It would have been leveled. That's a crude bomb. I don't think we understand that. People that haven't been to Manhattan, they have no concept of what Brooklyn, Staten Island. We saw what happened with Staten Island here recently with the Great Storm. Not that it would have been destroyed, it would have been leveled. You couldn't even find those places. Just one little small bomb. Just one. Yes. Terrorist truck bombs using conventional explosiveness have a destructive force of 5 to 10 tons. Of dynamite. If they had had just one crude weapon, they would have leveled basically all New York. There's nothing to New York but the northern, the country, and the city. The banking industry, one of the most powerful centers of the world, the nucleus of every kind of vile, wicked thing. I'm reading this because I want to show something here. Yah's going to bring it all down, Yisrael. Yeah? Hallelujah. To understand the sophisticated nuclear warhead, to understand a 100,000 ton or 100 kiloton of explosive force, this is a descriptive analogy to give us understanding. One standard nuclear warhead on a US or British, not a submarine from Brazil, not one from Chile, not one from Uruguay, not one from Panama, not one from Mr. Chavez, Venezuela, only on the British and the U.S. Trident submarines, has an explosive force equal to 100,000 tons of conventional high explosive. What does that imply? If a rudimentary bomb, if what we call the terrorists had the construct of that, it would have taken down Brooklyn, Manhattan, and Staten Island would have been leveled. That's one just crude bomb. Crude. On one Trident submarine, it has the force of 100 times more powerful than the terrorist bomb discussed above. So just one Trident submarine, as I said, just one, off the coast of South Carolina. One in New York, it would take out the state of New York, the state of New Jersey, the state of Delaware, the state of Pennsylvania. It would take out the whole, just one submarine. Life would be non-exist. The poisoning of the elements of the air and the drifting of the winds that would bring death to everyone. Is that the mind of Yah? He commands us to love our enemies as we love ourselves. You don't pour that on your enemy. You don't drop Agent Orange on your enemy and cause the babies and these maple bombs that their flesh burns like a fire. That's a damn sadistic mind. And you defend that, you coward out of hell. Denounce it. Bring it down. She's not a great nation. She's not a powerful nation. She's a damn coward of a nation. She's been raised up by Yah with the entity of her throne in the hands of her Shatan. That's a fact. She's not great. She's a wicked nation. We've learned her ways well. We got to come out of her. Yisrael, we must understand the simple things of life. We always want to understand the complexities of life. In order to foster the ability to understand the complex things, you've got to understand the small things, the things that are insignificant as we reason in ourselves as to the significance of the matter. You that were in the Marines, Akmikaya, my friend David, they were all in the Marine. It was one thing that the Marines taught you, and they looked at that specifically. Correct me if I'm wrong, and I know I'm not wrong. When one would lace up their boots in the Marine, they had to be cognizant that the left string always first over the right. See, he's shaking his head. If you're cognizant of the left string always, that small detail, then you congratulate to details that are far greater than that. Always in the Marines, the left string over the right. No, you don't right over left. Left over right. Bring it through left over right. Left over right. And all the Marines' boots are laced the same. Not so in the Army. Not so in the Navy. It was always that way. And if we are not cognizant of those things that we perceive to be insignificant, then we're not going to be apprehensive or comprehensive of the things of great magnitude. What are you saying, man? If we don't pay attention to me, how are you going to pay attention to you? If I don't pay attention to me, how can I pay attention to you? That's a false analogy. I'm not going to read all this. I'm going to read a few more things, and then I want to preach a little bit, all right? Then I'll get back one more week, all right? One more Shabbat. Is that all right, Zakim? All right, then. So these liars tell you to buy guns and hoard up your bread and your beans and pack them away. And so when all this devastation began to commence upon the earth, you can eat. It shows you where our thoughts are, isn't it? The God of that damn greedy belly of yours. Shows you everything. There's no trust in Yah. He rained them down meat to the full of every foul, clean bird it was, and they were not contaminated. Arzachin taught us all of those plagues come not nigh. Even in the book of Jubilee, it says not even a damn firstborn of a dog of Yisrael was dead. Not even a dog. Not even a dog. Not even one dog. And we think we're going to save ourselves. We have been purchased by the most magnificent power to purchase, by the dumb of Yahshua. And you think you're going to save yourself? We've done ourselves disservices by feeding ourselves, haven't we? So let's eat the bread, the lechem of life. Let us eat the living bread. Let us drink the living water of Almighty Yahweh. Hear this. The economic chaos. Now, this is an example of what the Cabrina Institution gives us as far as the economic. How are you going to buy something? From who? Where are you going to buy? And there are people that are so gullible, they buy that. Oh, Brother Shaw's a man of God. He is a man of God. I won't fight him. He is of his God. Shaul says, Lords, Baals, you got many of them. And them damn filthy things you call gods, you got so many. Man, he used that word. He say that about God. Damn God. Damn your God. You don't even serve the one you think is in the book you call the book of God. Damn you and your filthy, wicked God. You can't even tell me where that word originated from. They just took a damn dog and turned it around backwards. D-O-G and G-O-D. You cowards, you get a little afraid of that because you still hold on to the fervor of your damn your gods, damn them. Yeah. Listen to this, the chaos, what are you going to buy? Who are you going to buy? Or you're not going to be able to buy a cell unless you have the mark. They're so ignorant. They're saying the same thing Benny Hinn says. And T.D. Jakes, I don't say what they say because it takes a laborious effort. You got to labor. You got to understand. You got to search the book from beginning to end. You got to go back. I awakened this morning. I've been studying not what I was going to talk about today, but matters that are vitally important unto us. We must have men to stand. And as they would say on the day, stand flat-footed and know what they're saying. We have to know what we're saying. We can't be little boys. I'm not going to get up here and laugh and ha, 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 yee. Because you never see a smile on my face. We must be sober men that are wise in their words, have impactual detonation in one's bosom. It says this, economic chaos. If Britain decide to use one of its standard Trident submarine nuclear warheads against a Middle East threat. Why is it that the Middle East is threatening Britain and Britain need land to grow food for the people there, but it's always someone threatening them? No one is threatening us. No one. Mr. Chavez, he talk his talk. It's just like you, a bully saying, "Ah, you come over here." When I was a kid, I saw drawing this line. You step over that. Step over this line. Look at him. And you walk over the line. Well, you know, man, I scared of you. I tell you what, come over this line right here. You knew you had him on the first line. You walk over the second line. I ain't trying to go nowhere with you, man, but I tell you what, this is my last time over this line right here. You step over that line. You step over that line. What you gonna do, man? You know you got him. You know he's scared of you. You know you're gonna whip the fight him. I got you now. What do you want to do? I don't want to fight, man. I just, you know, I ain't ready to fight you, man. I'm not. So there is no nation that is threatening us. Those 19 men that they said came in the flights, September 11, 2002, it was 19 men. And you bomb a nation because you said that that kingdom collaborated with them. You kill the babies, you cause your nuclear waste weapons. Babies are sick today and they're dying. We have opportunity, we do right unto all men. If a stranger come among Yisrael, he abides in the Torah of Yah. You entreat him as one that is born a Yisraelite. Even an Edomite in the fifth generation, they can enter into the bed of Almighty Yah. Yah says to you, don't you mock Edom. Don't you mock the seed of Edom. Don't think you are high and mighty because you are the same ones that transgress. You are the same ones that have done every kind of damn filthy thing. You've laid with every kind of damn filthy God. Your black God, your white God, your brown God, your yellow damn dirty God. You've done every kind of damn filthy thing there is to do. And you think you're better than an Edomite. You wouldn't even know a damn Edomite if he slapped you in the face. Yeah. You just don't mock nobody. I don't care how wrong you've been done. You don't mock. You don't try to take vengeance. Vengeance is yours. He's going to repay all nations that have done Israel wrong. Yeah. Hell, I can't get but one or two, but he's going to get them all. He's going to get them, their children, children, and their children. Hell, he's going to dig them up out of the ground and get them. Yeah. It's a terrible thing to fall into the hands of the living Abba Yah. It's not some little thing you fall. It's a thing that is you can express in terminology. So if they decide, listen to how this article is constructed. My mind is always analyzing the words of people. Listen now. It says, if Britain decides to use the standard Trident submarine nuclear warhead against a Middle East threat, radioactive fallout could land. Listen now. This is what could land. Where? In the oil production area. Isn't that a bastard? Isn't that a dirty bastard? Isn't that a bastard? Yeah. That is a mamzia. Okay, I say it with a little dignification. Isn't that a mamzia? It's a dirty bastard. He doesn't know. You see how this article is constructed? That even the radioactivity will fall in the oil enriched. You understand? See, it's the oil baby that keeps the nations running. They love you driving them big gas hogs like we got them. They love that. It will fall into the oil producing area. If it did, the area would likely stop production. What does that mean? The average plate of an American, the food has traveled minimum 3,200 miles. So if there's no diesel, no oil, how do you get to Walmart or WeMart? Or and buy low and eat high on the hog? How do you get there? We'll likely stop production, and if production continued, we would buy radioactive oil. Since the Middle East supplies the world with so much oil, decreased production may trigger economic chaos. If the oil stopped flowing, baby, the diesel machinery that runs the nations of Britain, Russia, and America, it's going to grind to a halt. And the only thing they can do is drop the bomb on you, baby. Get your diesel, process your gas, put it in your this hog-loving nation that love filthiness. And you call yourself burning down to Walmart, and you're burning your own damn heart out, and you're killing yourself with that. At every field, every farm you pass by, you don't even see bugs like you used to, do you? You travel on the road. I look at that all the time. When we first moved here, that is the truth, honestly. From Monroe to here, you almost got to wash the windows. You don't have to do that now. You don't have to do that. I mean, here come a big green with splatter, pow! Here come one that is brown and red, pow! Here come one that is gray, boom! Here come a silver spot, bang! Here come every fluorescent color, boom, boom, bam! Where in the world? You can't see a thing. Such richness of the composition of their bodies, you put water on that thing, it wouldn't, might not even take it, or would it? That's stopping. And scrub it off. Can you imagine the devastation? And these men telling you to buy gold, they are dogs, they're liars, they're greedy dogs, they can't have enough. You little mama, don't buy no gold. You bath the tears out on, you're struggling. Don't buy no gold. Buy this truth. Yeah. Buy Yahshua. Yeah. It doesn't cost you nothing but to repent. Yeah. Make teshuvah. Yeah. Turn around from your wicked ways. Yeah. Let somebody tell you your sins, my bath of Zion. Come on, man. Listen, British farmers only produce enough food by themselves to support 12 million of the British population. Not even a third. They only produce that much food. That's why they're stealing and robbing and pillaging the nation or the continent we call Africa. And they're robbing these corrupt damn leaders, giving them guns to create tribal tension. And they rent all the acreage, and they grow their food. They're pumping death into their soil. They're drilling the underwater wells and pumping the water to supply food for these greedy dogs in Britain. That's what it is. They can only support Britain, 56 million, nearly 100 million people. If Britain used one of the nuclear warheads, it could cost Britain and others of the world greatly. How would Britain people feed themselves if there is little fuel for transportation, food, and the world economy in chaos? So what are you going to buy? Like I said, what are you going to buy? That's why I keep asking the question, what are you going to buy? What are you going to buy? You go into the store and buy you some bok choy? You want you some collard greens smothered in mushrooms and some whole gravy on the side? Want you a ribeye steak? Medium rare. Gotta have me some sweet butter. We're stupid, my friend. You're feeding your babies the radioactive milk that flows out of the titty of a cow that's eating the grass that is death. And mama, you're eating the steak that is full of death, and you're feeding your babies titty milk that is nothing but death. Don't let these liars tell you there's only one survival. There's only one assurance. That is our faithful obedience unto the Torah of Yah. He let them out and they ate. And they ate. They knew where to get water. Speak to the rock. But it's bitter. It's the bitterness of your sins against Yah. It may be bitter going down, but once it settles in the belly, it turns sweet as coconut water. I want to read one more thing, and I want to introduce some Dora here. It talks about the nuclear explosion produced an electromagnetic pulse, EMP. An EMP can travel. Can I explain that in my ignorance of the terminologies as I have pondered this? The electromagnetic pulse is that you drop a bomb here, and it began like a ripple effect. You can feel it in Monroe, stronger and stronger in Charlotte. That's what the electromagnetic pulse is. An EMP can travel at the speed of light. What is the speed of light? 186,000 miles per second. I like to go out at times at night when I maybe need to walk to the dining hall. I like to shine my light up. Because there's one thing about light, it travels until it contacts something that is solid. You may not see it, but it's even from a little flashlight, you go boom, 186,000 miles a second. And it falls until it hits something. It must hit an object, and then it dissipates. So I'll go out there and say, all right, light, I'm gonna see where you're going now. And I'll just shine up in the heavens. You don't see it once you turn it on, but it's gone. You can't see 186,000 miles a second how something is traveling. That's how fast the electromagnetic pulse. Drop here, Georgia, you feel it. Within, it's not even seconds. It travels at 186,000 miles across a wide area and peaks and packs enough punch to wipe out or make unreliable electronic banks and business records, further adding to the economic chaos. I'm going to stop on that. In essence, that these electromagnetic impulses, that there in New York, all of the transactions and transitions of the world market, you can't even function. Can you imagine trying to restore something of that magnitude? Can you understand the ships of the water trying to navigate when there is no GPS and no navigating tools to do that? What mind thinks of something like that? That's a mind that is birthed out of the darkness of hell. It is the mind of Nahash says, I'm going to extend, I'm going to rise up above the throne of Almighty Yah, and I'm going to be like him. You play with fire, I will bring some fire down on your people. You want to fire fights with fire. I'll fight you with fire. It will be total chaos. There's nothing you're going to buy, Israel. There's nothing you're going to get. You can scrounge off the land, but you will die from the land as well. Everything you eat will be so poisonous, you're not going. We're going to have to eat one thing. That is the lechem, the bread of life. We're going to have to eat Torah. That's why we must do one thing in this hour. We must hide it. We must conceal it in our hearts that we will not chata, we will not sin purposely and transgress the Torah of Yah. When we hear the word of Yah, we don't allow the opposition of our juvenile ways to oppose what Yah says. He sends forth his word to heal us and to correct us. It is his muzah to discipline us. And we need that, Yisrael. You need it all the time. How many times do you correct your child? One time a day, and that's it, one in 1 year? We must constantly be corrected. We must constantly be reminded. We can't allow the arrogance of our pride to rise up against Yah. That's not me. It is us. It is us. We are wicked. We are selfish. We've been taught to be selfish. We are self-righteous. We think we are right. Yet they have pride. No! Damn it, you got pride. Anytime you can't see yourself in the reflection of your own wrong, you got pride. Well, I'm not. Yeah, you're that way. His nature has always been prideful and full of conceit. And to say we're not, that's why we must be warned about our pride. You elevate your damn wicked self, think you don't have it, you do have it. There ain't a sin in this damn world I haven't committed to. There's not been a wicked thought that hasn't caused her no different than her. You think you're righteous, you're not worth a damn thing. It's only by the mercies, the tender kindness of Yah, testimony of Yahshua, that's why we cry, Yada Yah. That's why it must be a sweet fragrance in our mouths. Sweet. Everything Yah speaks to us, that's us. Everything you read, that's you. Everything you read, that's you. Everything I see in this book, I see my reflection. I'm not that way. I know you're a damn hypocrite. You're sanif, you're false, you have duplicity. Hallelujah. I want to read, hallelujah, the great destruction that is near, that is upon us as a nation, what it shall render the people to. If there's an expressive dialogue of the events and what shall take place, is found in the book of Lamentation. Echa. The cries of Jeremiah, Lamentations. As Yah speaks here of the deplorable states, Lamentations in chapter 4, I want to begin. Of the deplorable state of a nation of people that have resisted his instructions. We resist instructions. We get mad when someone tells us something. And we're so subtle with our wickedness, we don't want them to know that we're upset. That's a damn coward. I'd rather you let me know you're upset. And we're too ignorant to think that no one knows that we're upset. We get upset about the least of things. When someone tells you something to strengthen, when someone speaks to you to cause the resolve of your strength in your bosom, you just rejoice. I don't care if it's correcting. Whatever it is, even if you have not done it, receive it. It will be a great blessing to you. When a man starts his ways are pure, everything that is said to him is pure. If he's defiled, I believe in there's nothing pure to him. That's not me. That is you, man. Tell me what I've done. Oh, man, stop that. Oh, no, that ain't me. That, why is it that it's someone else, but it's not you? Tell me. We get quiet, don't we? As the old proverbial speech, everything you see in someone else, you're just looking at you. She is so wicked. Well, I am glad I like that. You Pharisaic beast of hell. I'd rather be the publican that takes where I should not take and rob and steal. And when the word him, I'm a damn thief, Yah. Why am I a wretched thing undone? Than to think that I have some kind of spiritual, intellectual pattern upon matters, that I'm strong. That's so silly. I don't ever want to get to that point because I need him. And anytime I get to that point, I don't need him. That's why we don't need Yah. That's why our minds are not on Yah, because you don't need him. I don't ever want to get to that point. I'll get to that point when he say, get up. Hallelujah. I want him to make me and mold me and shape me continuously. I want to go down and say, Yahweh taught us the potter's house, all right? Yah intended for every vessel to be a vessel of gold. He didn't intend for them to be clay. Every vessel. I want to read this in Lamentation chapter 4, verse 1. This is a nation who has lost the prosperity of the consciousness of Yah, his Torah. We have lost the power of the Edah, the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach. And he speaks to a nation as the consequences of the great agony that shall befall. That is why this nuclear holocaust, this offering, is going to have to go through the fire. The fire came upon Mizraim to show us the death of Yah's destruction. It was not nigh unto the people of Almighty Yah. He said, but this fire, you're going through. He brought them through the Red or the Yam Shuf. Shoes without mud, they went dry shot. He said, but you're going to sense this fire. He caused them to go down into the dungeons of the death of the heated furnace. And they did not lose one singe of hair. This fire, you're going to denounce everything for him. You're going to lose everything. You're going to lose mama, daddy, brother, sister. You're going to lose everything. You're going to lose your own life. And that's a fact. It says here, you can sense the heart of Jeremiah crying. He says here, as Yah reveals unto him, Lamentations 4:1. He says, how has the Zahab, the gold, become Amam? It's dim. You can't even see the beauty of the gold, but they're telling you to buy gold and silver. How has it become dim? How is the most fine gold or the most precious gems changed? The stones of the Kodash place are poured out into the top of every street. That which is Kadosh, which is reserved unto Yisrael, they're pouring it out, trying to find some kind of resolve for an appeasement to their flesh. There's a powerful message on the stones, and one day I'm going to teach that. I want to show you something. Hallelujah. It says the precious sons of Zion. This is what we are comparable to. The sons of Tizayon. They are comparable to fine gold. That's what the sons are. That's what the sons are. And the world tells you you're nothing. You have no sense of worth. And you buy that damn because you got to have a big house. You got to have the fine. What is the finest of clothes? Some faggot designed it. Some faggot pimp popping bull dagger butch hoe. That was a beautiful pair of shoes I looked at. And when I read up, I searched to see who this designer was. Called himself married to another man. I said, nowhere in hell if there was a dollar, I would not buy them. Yeah. I'm not just putting anything on my feet. No more than I'm putting some Nike tennis shoes on. And so when I went to see this dog here flung, I said, this faggot dog, you couldn't give me the shoe to wear. That's why the bath of Tizayon, you have the skills to design and create beautiful wear. You're too damn lazy. We are wicked and we flatly don't give a damn. The world has impressed us, so I want my woman dressing like that. No, just dress kadosh for me, baby. Yeah. Dress clean and beautiful. Yeah. Hell, you got time for everything else. But no time for your beauty. Yeah. We are distinguished people. We are pala people. I don't care if you don't like me. I don't care if you get upset with me. I'm a warrior. I'm in a battle. And the cause of this is for the stake of the kingdom identity. It's greater than me. I'm nothing. The precious son of Zion comparable. If you want to compare the son of Zion, you look at the finest of gold comparable to fine gold. He said, how are they esteemed now as an earthen pitcher? That's why in every great house, as Zakin taught us, there's a varium of all kinds of vessels, some that are earthen. Now we should be compared to fine gold. Yeah. And now we're esteemed as porous earthen pitchers. And even when you put them in the kiln, I tell you what, you can put the gold pitch in the kiln. It's still gold. It may lose the form and the shape, but it's still pure gold. You put the porous earthen pitcher in the thing, and if you don't seal the porous pores, it's going to crack every time. And that's why after the second time, the potter field was there. He threw it out. Yeah. You got to come up to the standard of Yah. Yeah. He threw it out. It wasn't worth a damn thing then. Now we become as earthen vessels. The work of the hand of the Yatsah, the potter, of the one that forms. Look at verse 3. That's very dynamic. Even the sea or the Tanim, even this Nahash, even the Nahash, even the spirit that rises up in us, even the sea monster draws out of the breast. Even The monster of the sea draws out of the breast of the wealth and the plethora of life that sustains it. And yet we as the sons of Yisrael, we are drawn from a titty that has no life in it. We're drawn from our own breast that presents nothing. We have no power of his shad that we're hidden his word in our bosom that we will not sin. We're just like little damn boys. We get upset. We get upset too quick. That is truth, my amen. These boys today, the least of the little thing, because you know why they get upset? Because they think highly of themselves. I can rebuke you, but that's all right. But don't rebuke them. Don't correct them. I will mind. Don't tell them where they're wrong, but they can say, oh, yeah, I can start talking that Ema Sabea. I can put a stick on her head, put this word, this rod of correction there. Oh, yeah, you know, Riak, I saw that sister. She did that one day. Tell me what you did, man. I can tell you enough about me, not only to write a book that the world books couldn't contain it and you would get bored. So what you need to know about me is not worth a damn. What you need to know is about you, your superficiality, and your damn hypocrisy. You're not right. She's not right. No, it's not she's not right. You're not right. She needs to get it right. No, you need to get it right. My husband need to get it right. No, honey, you need to get it right. My wife need to get right with you. You need to get right with the Lord. No, man. You better get right with your Lord. Hallelujah. I can accentuate my wife's fallacies and her wrongs, but when I take a deeper introspective look at me, hell, mine's a monumental to hers. Talk to me, man. Or we'll come on. Hallelujah. In a state of time that is so deplorable, so corrupt, he says, for even the sea monster, verse 3, draws out of the breast. They give suck to their young ones. They feed them with the necessary nutrients and nourishment. He says, the daughters are my people. He says, they are akhza, they are cruel. The daughters are my people. They are fierce. They are verbalant. Verbalant is that they love to talk. You go YouTube and you see these women talking back to their men. Boy, they shoot them down like you shoot a bird down. I'll kick you. I'll do this and I'll do that. And I'll do this and I'll do that. It's all of that. And they put it up there. Simple-minded people looking for something. I see it because people subscribe to our site. I'm not going to subscribe to that with this mess on there. You subscribe all you want to here, but I'm not subscribing there. I don't even do it. I saw this little clip the other day. The woman, she walks up to this guard and she just, you mother, this, you son of a, you this. He said, you heifer. He took out his taser and just shot it, boom, and she fell down like a, she just fell straight to the ground. I said, man, she fell like a log, just went, bam. They are verbalant, they are akha. That's what the Torah says. I want to show you something, Bath. I want to show you something, Akibata. Here, you better be precious as the gold. He says, the daughters of my people, is this what Yah says, the daughter of my people? Does he say that they'll become cruel? They'll lock an ostrich in the wilderness. He said that's what they're like. He said the tongue of the suckling, or the tongue of the yanach, or the tafte yanach, the tongue of the suckling child, cleaves to the roof of his mouth because there is no moisture, there is no caring for the child, for thirst. The young or the early, but the young children ask bread, and no man break it for them. Where are you going to get bread from? No man. This is the lamentation of Yeremiah. This is the cry. This is the echa of Yeremiah. We're in this time where we're going to see the devastation, where the tongue of the child, as we've seen in the past, whereby you look at the little babies on the continent of Africa, the little bellies are swollen, and we think they got a lot of food in their big belly. Not like us in this country. Our bellies are big because we got a lot. Their bellies are swollen because of the parasites and the diseases and everything that goes down. And their little eyes, and we see their little bones and their little skinny. And the tongue stick to the roof of their mouth. There's no suck. There is no life. And that's what's the problem with yeast right now. We're talking, but we're not saying a damn thing. We're talking loud. It was a song in the day, talking loud and saying nothing. Come on, man, you're talking loud, but you ain't saying nothing. And that's all we do. We're talking loud, but we're not saying anything of worth, any wealth at all. We like to get together and expose what little we know to each other. I like to show him, he likes to show me. One called me yesterday and said, no, she said, well, we got to reason. I said, no, sir, no, ma'am. We're not going to reason. I'm not going to reason with you from a platform that you don't know. I know what I am saying. And I'm not reasoning with you. That's why y'all say, come, let us reason. He knows what he is saying. He is the one that gives us reason for the tikvah that is in us. I'm not going to come. I said, no, ma'am, I'm not going to come to sin to you. No. I'm not. You have deduct from that. I said, I will show you what the scripture is. Where you don't even know. Huh? You have deduct that by your own reason and your own intellectual proudness and your own thought of discussing that with others on the telephone. And so that's what you all deduct. I said, you don't even know what it means. And I'm not afraid to say that. Hallelujah. Listen. It says this in Lamentation 4 and 5. 4 and 5. They did feed delicately. They that did feed with such sumptuous nature or delicately are desolate. They're sure mean. They're stupefied. They're appalling. There's nothing there for them in the streets. What are you going to buy? Tell me. This is a true picture of his nature, nation that has transpired, and it shall be in its full throttle in this hour. He said they were brought up in scarlet embraced dunghills. Those that had the beauty of the aura of the Torah upon them, now they want the dunghills or the ashputh. They want the places where people go and put their feces, their excrement, the dung out of their buttocks. That's where they go. They embrace that. We embrace some of the most filthiest things. We embrace some of the most vilest of things that we once embraced truth and we love truth. And now we embrace that which is of the dunghill. He said, for the punishment now of the iniquity of the daughters of my people is greater than the punishment of the sin of Sodom. What did he send down on Sodom and Gomorrah? Did he send the fire down? Did he send the fire down? And he said, the sins of the daughters of my people is greater than them. You think that our sins are not greater than Sodom and Gomorrah? You think that our activities are not greater than Sodom and Gomorrah? He said, the sins of the daughters of that which bring forth the birth of the life of Joshua is greater than that nation. And he said to Lot, get out of the damn house. I'm going to send my Ebrah, the fire, down. And there was nothing left there. The wicked wife turned and look, and she became a pillar of salt. And if y'all say she's there to now, she's still there. The sin of my people is greater. And the sin of that nation caused the nuclear thermal fire yard to come down. What in the hell you think is coming down on us? He's got to get it out. He's got to cleanse us. He's got to wash us. That's what we about to hear. We about to quit pretending. He said, the sins of the daughters of my people is greater, Gadol. Of greater magnitude. It is Rabbah, of numerically unmeasurable. He sent fire down, didn't he? Were there babies there? Did he burn the babies? He burned them all. He will not do that. Okay, well, can I move a little farther? He said that it is greater than the punishment of the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah, that was overthrown in a moment. See, how do you measure that moment? You say it was like that? Well, that's not a moment, because if it's measurable, it's not a time. Time is infinite. That's why I say I know I can see 93 million because I know where that sun is. It doesn't look like it was a few miles away, does it? But that's what scientific proudness has taught me, that it's 93 million. And there are stars. The stars we see, they're light years away, hundreds of millions. I know I can see that far. I can see a long, long way. Look how marvelously he made us. And we are so damn unappreciative we can't see the beauty of us. We look at a dirty, twisted-headed whore in Hollywood and want to emulate that crazy, deranged whore. These effeminate men that are fagged to the bone, dress worse than women. Skinny jeans, skinny tights. They were overthrown in a moment, and no hand was there to prevent it. No man stayed them. He talks about the Nazarenes, those that have abstained themselves from the unclean things, have not touched the unclean things of the world, have not given themselves over unto that. He said, her Nazarenes are purer than snow. They were labah, they were whiter than milk. They were more ruddy in body than rubies. You hear that? Now they say that's the word that describes the Edomites, ruddy, atmone. That's how dumb this generation is. And these young nut heads and fruit heads and Turk heads. And white folks say, you see, it was whiter, but Laban doesn't mean damn that it's a white man or a black man. I'm not afraid to see that. You cowards are afraid. I'm not. It says their polishing was as a sapphire. Their appearance is hashach. It is blacker than a coal. They are not known in the streets. Their skin cleaves to their bone. It withers and has become like stick. There is nothing to dine upon. There is nothing to satisfy the thirst and the need of not only the physiological but the spiritual man. They pine away. They wait. There's no love for Yah. There is no time before his presence to cry out, woe is me, Yah. Why is this? He says in verse 9, they that be slain, those that are killed by the nuclear bombs, those that when the bombs fall, those that be slain are better than they that be slain with hunger. When the famine, when death overtakes, it's better. Just say, nuclear drop on me. Take your 45 and go boom, 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 boom. Drop it all in me before I fall to the ground, because this is not just a hunger. I know there's a famine in the world today, not for the eating of bread, but the hearing of the word. There will be no sound of Yah's Torah. It will only be hidden in the heart of those that have the power of the testimony of Yeshua HaMashiach, and those that keep the mitzvah of Yah, and they love not their life unto the death. And so those that are taken out, is better for them to be taken than for the pains of this hunger, of this death to overpower them and watch their babies part away. Listen. For they pine away, stricken through, said they so emaciated, what? Stricken through for want, fruit of the field. Where are you going to harvest? Your gold is dim, your silver, you all that have silver. There was a brother, I think 2 or 3 years ago, he sent me a bag of silver coins. Have you traded them all in? You still hold them. She traded some in. You get a nice penny when you traded some in? You didn't? How many have you traded in? 4 of them? He sent me a nice bag of them. How much you get? Who took you? Who took you? You better tell me. Who? Tell me again. Zakein who? We got Zakein Benjamin, David, Mahaliyah. So how much you get? For 4 coins, 100 or 200? Oh. This brother sent me a bag of coins. I didn't want that. Because I'm not trusting in no damn silver. I don't care if she spent it. Really. I said, you want it? If he had been, I said, you want it? I would have gave it to him. If you know me, you know me. If you don't know me, I frankly don't give a damn. I didn't want it. I appreciate what the brother did. He left his country. He went to the Philippines. He said, because the people here are so arrogant, so wicked. Well, hell, the folks in the Philippines with their gods, they're as dogmatic about their damn Catholic gods, and their gods no different. Their pride is no different there than it is here. No different. I am in the world, but I'm not of the world. Hell, I don't need to go and secluse and recluse myself to any damn strange place. I want my light to so shine. Say, nobody seeing my light out there in the damn jungle but the bees and the birds. Now I want my light to shine among the people of Yah. I want my strength to shine. I don't want to be to myself. What a damn selfish, wicked, unpassionate concept. That's what it is. I don't give a damn what you say. I want to be with Yah's people. You know what Moshe did that didn't. He chose rather to suffer with the people of Yah. So I'd rather suffer with the people of Yah than to enjoy my own loneliness for a season, than to enjoy the sin for a season. Come on, Yisrael. So those that are slain with the sword are better than they which are slain with hunger. For they pine away, stricken with one of fruit of the field. There's nothing you're going to buy. There will be no fruit to buy. You're not going out here on the peach tree and pick nothing. You're not going to survey the land and find the edible things and eat it. We're going to have to eat truth. That's why we must buy it now. We must hoard it up. We must buy truth, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. I will get to that again, all right? It's vital that you understand that, Yisrael. You must buy that. You must spend all you got for that, not silver nor gold. Tell these land dogs to go to hell. They're liars. Their gold is going to become dim. You're not going to be able to buy anything. Listen. It talks about this beautiful woman. This woman represents us, the bride of Yahshua HaMashiach. It said, the hands of the pitiful woman, it calls her a Rachmani, a Rachmani. I had to examine that word. I had to place it in so I could enunciate it right. It is called a Rachmani. She is a woman that is very compassionate, that is loving, that love her children, that love her house. It says, the hands of the pitiful woman, she has mashal, she has boil, she has bacon, she has put in her child, it says, she has son, their own children, not your child, but their own children. Why? They were their meat in the Sheba in the time of destruction. They have baked their little babies. They have cooked their babies. They have baked them. They have boiled them. And they have eaten them. It would have been better than a man to die. That's what we better die unto sin. We better die and impale ourselves continuously of the lust and the greed of the flesh and the ruach, the spirit, perfecting that which is kadosh in the sight of Almighty Yah. They sodden their babies, they bake them in an oven to eat. Rachmani, a woman that is pitiful, that a very compassionate, loving woman and kind and sweet. A woman like that, her own child, just like the nature of the house of those two women that went before Shlomo, one represented Yehuda, and one represented the Ephraimite. That's what it really. And so the one says, no, the one that Yehuda says, this is my baby, she stole it. I have the right to the covenant of Yah. And Shlomo said, I'll tell you what, I'm going to take the sword of Yah, and I'm going to divide. I'm going to give you your heritage. And the one that said, no! Ephraim said, no, I know I'm sin, I'm a whore, I'm filthy, I'm foul. Give her the baby. Give her the oracles. If she got them, my children will interact with her children. There will be birth, and my children will know the soundness of Yah's Torah. We read this stuff like it's some kind of little job nickel butt story, and we can read and say, well, I know what that means. Oh, brother, brother, you read that? Come here, let me show you something. Show you something what it says in the Torah. Everything represents us in the book. Everything. Everything. Everything in the book is about Yisrael. Everything represents us. Every detail is about us. The hands, the yam of the pitiful woman, she starts her child. And she eats because she is hungry. And she eats because of her Sheba, her destruction of the daughter of my people. Verse 11, it says here, now that's where we go into the fire. It says, Yah has kala, he has accomplished his fury, his chemach, his great indignation. Verse 11, he has poured out his fierce anger, his af, and has kindled what? A fire. He's going to kindle the fire. And when the fire burns, everybody runs. He has kindled the fire. Where? In Zion. Where is that among his people? Into Zion. He has kindled the fire into Zion. And it has devoured, the foundation thereof. There is no foundation. Where is the foundation of truth? It has devoured the foundation. This is what the nuclear weapon does. This is why Yah has raised up this nation, given her this power. She's going to try to decimate the foundations of Yah. We're going to burn it up. You don't have to burn up no books. You don't have to burn them. Evangelist Horn would always say that. They're going to take this Torah and burn it up. Well, you know, this fire right here is going to burn it up. The mind of man will have no cognizance of what Torah says. That's why we need to eat and get fat. We need to eat and get fat, Yisrael. Feed me like a hog. A hog will eat as long as you feed it. We need to eat until we want no more. And then when you eat the truth of Yah, you will never be satisfied in the sense, because there is always a rising up in one's own bazaar, in one's bazaar, in one's flesh, in one's own carnal mind that is enmity against the Torah of Yah. It is not subject, and neither and never indeed can it submit unto the Torah of Almighty Yah. Listen, in verse 12, the kings of the earth and all the inhabitants of the world would not have believed that the adversary and the enemy should have entered into the gates of Yerushalayim. He says here, the city of Yerushalayim represents the city of where the shalom of Yah is taught, right? This is the city. We are the city whereby his shalom dwells, where the insight of his shalom dwells in us. And what this implies, not only in the natural sense of what's in that city today, but it implies that even the nations or the people that we come in contact will not believe that you have changed so much. You used to talk about Yah and say you love Yah. Now you are just jamming and rocking and rolling and bumping and grinding and doing the same things I do. They would not have believed that you're doing things in a subtle way and you're sneaky and you try to get by slithering the damn world. And they would not believe that you have opened the gates of your mind unto the destructions of hell. That's the implication that is greater than what we see in a natural form of the city of Yerushalayim. Even those that you esteem, they will look at you and say, man, what has happened to you? You're not even a hypocrite. They say, you're phony, you fake. Sure, they will say that. Yeah. I want the testimony of Yahshua to speak for me. Oh, I know the song says, let the works I do speak for me. See, if we understand the works we do, the mitzvah we asah, and it is Yah that asah to form, to fashion, to shape us. So that is in the power of the testimony of Yahshua. Let that speak for me. I want that to speak for me. Not how nice I was. Of course, they would say he cussed or he cursed. Don't even know what Ara is. Don't even know what Kala is. They would say that. His language was crude. He was mad. Well, any Sadiq man, the Torah said the righteous man, he is mad because of the oppression. If a righteous man doesn't get mad at the oppression of what is taking place, he's a wimp. He's a phony little boy. He's a little boy. He's not even a man. He's a boy. He's a boy. It says in verse 13, for this is the sin. Why? Why is this happening? For the sins of the prophets, the Navi'im, the prophets, and the iniquity of their Kohen, the leaders that administer the Torah of Yah, and have shed the blood of the just in the midst of her. They have wandered as blind men. Is not the blind leading the blind? The ivreth, those without the insight, the ayin, of the knowledge of Yah's truth, those that are boys that think they know and they don't know, the blind lead the blind and they both fall into a ditch. That's what Yah says. He says they have wandered as blind men in the street. They have polluted themselves with their own wickedness. They think they're right and they polluted themselves. That's why it's going to take the fire. It's going to take the fire, Yisrael, and the fire has to come from Yah. So that men could not touch even the garments of those that should have been their leaders. They can't even touch the garments. They can't even touch the keli, the clothing of those, because they're so filthy they see them. I was listening to this damn dog. What's his name? Bishop, one of T.D. Jake's boys. Bishop Noel Jones. I listened in astonishment. He had been married for 16 years. I didn't know. Someone sat up to our YouTube. I clicked on this, this, and that. And there it was. He was being interviewed by this other man. This other, they could be bishops, but they're not the Kohan. They're not the Zachin of Yah. And so they said to him, Bishop, why haven't you married? He said, because the net. What has someone has to do to get you? Throw out a net? He said, no, because I'm broader than that. In essence, he was saying, I lay with so many women. I got so many brands of women. I don't need a wife. And I looked at this bastard. I looked at this dirty dog and the many women in these whorehouses that are flirting themselves, not even like a whore. And they don't do a damn thing for them. And they take advantage. I looked at this bastard. I say, Yah, if you gave me the sword, I would kill him. Kill him. I say, Yah, your judgment upon him. But the people buy that. They love men like that. Yeah. A man like me, not many are going to love. I know that. That's my plot in life. And I'm fine with it. I don't mind that. You understand? Hallelujah. I don't mind that at all. I don't want them to love me. I don't want them to speak highly of me and esteem me highly. Because woe to you when men speak highly of you. I don't want men speaking highly of me. That's why the compliments, I don't even listen to that. Hallelujah. And that's a fact. I want to read a couple more things before I close. I did ponder things too long this morning. But that's all right. You'll get something out of it. You get one thing out of it that you need to get right, and we need to get right with Yah. Nothing else. Hallelujah. You're going to get that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The kingdom. This is something that is very beautiful here in the book of Sirach. I want to read this. The book of Sirach. I want to do this quickly here. Just listen to me. All right. It says in the book of Sirach, as he speaks to the kingdom of Yisrael, this is Yisrael, the nation, what we call the northern kingdom, which is 9 tribes, and then 9.5, and then the southern kingdom, all right, which is Yehuda. And these are the words that came from the mouth of the Nabi Elijah with Elisha. He speaks here in Sirach 48:1. It says, then the prophet Elijah arose like a fire. That's what a true Nabi arises like. Not these little effeminate boys that call themselves prophets and call themselves messengers of Yah. He rose like a fire, and his words burn like a torch lamp, burn like the Torah of Yah. That is what a messenger's word burns like. It burns like a torch of the lamp. He brought famine upon them. He brought famine. He brought death. What is the famine the land cannot produce? That's why you hear those. You know, someone posted on our web YouTube channel on the Zake. More people looking at that than they are me because of the invitation. And they posted under there, I'm glad that I answered the questions, all right. That you really don't even know when to keep Pesach because the word Abib. I know what the words are. It's not Abib, but Abi means. And if you search the Torah, it means the sighting of the barley. That's a damn lot. There is nowhere in the Torah. There is nowhere in the Torah. There is nowhere. Yah gave the luminaries a sign for his appointed times. Nowhere. But he says, you must cite the barley. You cannot see our forefathers looking for the barley to determine the first month and the time of the Moedim of Yah. I got something for him. Don't worry about it. He calls it, he's one of them damn Jews, what he is. I got him, though. I got him. I started to bust him up this morning, but I said, nah. Nah, I won't do it. I'll wait. I'll relax it. I'll answer it. All right. There's nowhere. You can search the Torah, you will find it nowhere. He said a famine. So how did they determine if you had to see the barley? These people are crazy. They take and deduct what they want. They establish things with that. I'm like, where is that? I ask people, where do you see that? Show me. Oh, well, you know, it means that's what the words avi or abi or abib, it means barley or the head of the grain. I say, but where did our forefathers, where did Moshe say, we got to cite the barley? They weren't doing the farming there in the wilderness. And they kept the Pesach of Yah. Talk to me. They come out of Mizraim. They were not in the promised land. People are so silly. They're so silly. That's why you need that. Understand the very signs, not to watch them, to worship them, but to understand. We got silly men, ignorant men as I. We hear something and we run with it. We hear it and we think we know something, so we throw it on someone else that they haven't heard it in the format you have, and we think we got something. I don't play that. I don't go that way. I'm a student. I'm a student of thorough research. I am a student of application. I am a student. There's nothing I can't do if I want to do it. I don't care what it is. But I'm a student of application. There's no motive in my life but what Torah says. I don't want to be a scientist. I want to be a Sadiq man of Yah. So we are so accustomed to hearing things. Can I show you an example? It's no different than a gossiper. You hear something or half of it. You hear the half of the truth, and you take it to someone. They take that half truth and they spread it like it's the truth. And that's the way we are. We hear someone say something. Well, you know that brother said that you got to see the barley wet. Show me, man. Someone write me and show me. Show me any place in the Torah, any in the writings of the book, any other books, any of the laws of the book. Show me where it says that. Show me where it says that. You're not going to find it. He put the moon, the sun, and the celestial bodies that we can determine the time. When there's a famine, when it was a famine, when there was a famine under Yosef 7 years, where were the fields? Where did they see the barley loaves? It was no barley, but they kept the Pesach of Yah. It was a famine. Everything they put in the ground, nothing grew. I will, man. Nothing grew. When there's a drought in the land, you go out there to Texas, boy, they put out all that corn. It comes up like that, all pretty, and all of a sudden it's just brown and nothing. The ground is crustated with great, the clay turns into nothing but crust. You can't even plow it. We haven't seen the famine. So how are you going to determine the Moed? Look up for redemption drawing nigh. It's a combination. That's why he doesn't put it in the hand of novice. That's why he doesn't put it in the hand of immature men. They just read something. This is how you determine. I got so much teaching on that. I can't teach it all. It's a sad thing. I just can't teach you. I could come in here and teach every day. I really could. Every single day. Every day I could teach 7 days a week. And every message would be dynamic in the sense that it will open the nuances of Yah's truth to you. I could teach every day until I die. Every day. I could teach every day. Every day. There are not many men can do that. These men spend hours to put together, they spend days to put together these little half an hour sermonettes. I don't deal with sermonettes. They read other men's book, and I don't read the men's books. I read the man's book. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Not these dogs. I don't read their books. Let me move quickly because we want to bless our little Yarameya. In Sirach 2, he said, Sirach 48:2, he brought a famine upon them, and by his zeal, he made them few in number. This is what this messenger did. He said, the famine, and by his zeal for Yah, their numbers began to deplete. By the word of Almighty Yahweh, he shut up the heavens. He caused the Shemayim to be shut. And also, 3 times, he brought down the fire. Now, I wanted to teach in reference of this with Revelation 13:11. I'll get back to that next week. I want to show you. This man brought down the fire. And what other man? Is not this false entity of hell that's going to cause the fire to come down? And he will deceive the nations of the earth. Look at this nuclear. Come on, look at that fire. When that big bomb jets through the heavens, it's like a rolling fire. 3 times he brought down fire. I will get back to this part next week. How splendid were you, O Elijah, in your wondrous deed, in your pala, in deeds that are distinctly different than the deeds of the world. And who has the right to boast, which you have? Who can talk like you? See, every man has not the right to boast, but this man had the right to boast. What about has the nuances of the understanding of the nuances of God? He has the power to boast in what he has. Who has the right to boast like you? Who did raise up a dead man from the death and his nephesh from the place of the dead by the word of Almighty Yahweh, the Most High, who brought kings down to destruction and famous men from their beds, who heard the rebuke of Yah in Sarai and judgment of his vengeance at Horeb. who anointed. That's what Yah has done. Who anointed kings to take revenge and prophets to succeed after him. He anointed one to succeed after him. He says to this messenger, and you were taken up by a whirlwind of fire. The enemy is going to try to drop it on us. But Yah says, I'm going to take you up by the whirlwind of fire. Yeah. He led them day by pillar of cloud. And at night, he's going to lead us by the fire of the light of the Torah that burns deep in us. He's near the lamp of Torah. He's going to guide us. He's going to take us to the perfect place, Yisrael. That is what's going to take us to the place of our perfect offering unto Yah. And an offering of Todah Yadah, that from the most frail and brokenness of body, it shall resonate into the heavens of Yah. That's the truth. He was taken up in a whirlwind of fire of the Ish, and a chariot with horses of fire. Now, if that's not shown enough bona fide there, that's bona fide. I watched Space Shuttle with Clips Discovery and all of them take off, and it's nothing but fire that rolls out of that bad boy. You understand? By the time that thing is up in the air, it's within minutes, it's traveling 2,500 miles a second. It's flying. When it reaches zenith, 25,000 miles an hour. Every 4 hours, it makes a revolution around the earth. But this man was taken up by the fire of the chariots of Yah. In the vehicle of heaven. Who was ordained at the appointed time. See, at the time of the season of the Moed, he was ordained for that. Your ordainment for the appointed time, for the season. It is written, what? This was his purpose, to calm the wrath of Yah before it breaks out in fury. This is what Yah is trying to do for us. He's trying to show us, stop doing what we're doing. Stop it. You don't have to be reminded. Our Akshavri said, stir up your pure mind by way of remembrance. To cause the impending destruction to be abated. That the full throttle of his Ibra is not poured out, Israel. To turn the heart of the fathers to the son. And above all, listen, it says this. Who has the book of Sharak? You have it? What? Read those last. And to what? I know. Read the last part. The comma, then what? To what? To restore, to bring back, to restore all the tribes of Yaakov. What does your rendition say? Of Yaakov. Yeah. To reform. Who is Yaakov? Who is Jacob? He is Israel. To reform the tribes, the Shebet, the branches of the branch, or the offshoots, the Shebet. We are the Shebet, we are the nation, we are the people, we are the tribe. We are the tribe to reform all of us. And that's why he sends messengers and simple men to reform us. What is the reform? As a change, isn't it? And this is for you. Blessed are those who saw you. Blessed are those that have seen Yahshua, but we are blessed even the greater. Because we have not seen, but yet we believe, Yisrael. Blessed are those that saw Elijah and those who have been adorned in his love. Why? For we shall surely live. We're going to live because you all sure live. We're going to live, Yisrael. That's why. We're going to live because he lived. We are blessed because we live by Emunah. He has chosen us to live that way. I'm going to endeavor to increase this on next Shabbat. Some things I want to read. And I don't like just reading like this. I like to define things as I go. And I didn't take enough time to define every aspect. I got to get back. These people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. We may need to have, what is the knowledge? The da'ats. We need to have the knowledge of understanding that we can discern. I know how to discern everything. You didn't know how to discern a damn thing. You're just wrong. You're wicked. You've taken what you have heard someone has said. That's all right. And you've taken that and you haven't even conformed it or transformed it whereby it is intelligible enough that you can say it. Hallelujah. I like listening to simple men that are not don't embellish things, and men that are not superficial. Just be real with me. You don't have to worry about me phoning with you, trying to pretend I'm something that I'm not. I'm not that way. Never have been that way. That's why I didn't like the young phony cats when I was in school. I didn't hang with them. I like the older cats, man. The older cats had something different. They were more genuine. I've watched how they were interact with each other, how straight they were. They were straight, even though they were thugs and hustlers, but they were still straight with each other. They know how to confess, man. Yeah, I took it down. You know, but I'm straight. I'll make it up, baby. All right, now, dog, you're going to have to do it right now. And that did not separate them. They still hustle together. These little young boys, I went to school with, they wore jitterbugs. They wore tennis shoes to school. I wore no tennis shoes. I wore shoes and big brim hats. That's how I went to school. I didn't wear that. I don't want no tennis shoes. Never liked tennis shoes. Ain't never been my thing. I didn't wear tennis shoes. I wore Converse to play basketball in. I had suede leather shoes back then. Buy me some shoes. Yah will rock you all. May the riches of Yah rest upon you all, Yisrael. May Yah bless you. Come on, my Zachin. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad Yahshua made you free? I know I am.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Yahweh, for this beautiful Shabbaton he has given us. We have entered into it without bringing our burdens, Israel. Yahweh has set us free through Yahshua HaMashiach. And let us purchase, let us buy this precious gold, his Torah, that has been tried, Israel. It has been proven in itself to be pure. There's no falseness that has been found in it, no impurities. And not only, there's two expressions that the Torah used, even concerning purchasing. And it's also to deal or know how to divide, Yisrael. We must learn how to divide even the Torah of Almighty Yahweh and how to use it wisely. You know, there are people that purchase things and they buy things. They go to yard sales, garages, and they may purchase an article, not even knowing the worth of it, for pennies. And then find out later it's worth thousands and millions of dollars. Well, Yahweh, he tells us to buy of him the Torah, the Mishpat. And there's no wealth and there's no price that can be put on it, Yisrael. Hallelujah. But yet he offers it. He gives it freely unto Yisrael. He tells us to buy of it, to purchase it, deal with it, learn how to use it, because it's of great wealth and great value, even to the health and the wealth and the livelihood of Yisrael. Hallelujah. So that knowledge, let us stand to our feet. Beautiful message, beautiful day. Yahweh has given us all breath, Yisrael. So let us barak him. Let's give him todah for everything and for all that he has given to the cold, the house of Yisrael. Abba Yahweh, we do barak you for this day, for the word that you have fed us, Abba Yahweh, that came forth from your throne room. We do barak all Yisrael, those are scattered abroad, Abba Yahweh, that you will continue to keep us, to nourish us, Abba Yahweh, and to strengthen us. We do barak you that for those that are listening by via live stream, those that have joined us here at Teshua Community, and Yahweh, protect us, keep us as you have, Abba Yahweh, through your faithfulness of your Torah, your rebuke, your messages, Abba Yahweh, and the Dhamma Yahshua HaMashiach. Take those that have come from near and afar home safely, Abba Yahweh. And in all things we do give you todah, we barak you. In the name of Yahshua HaMashiach, we do declare, hallelujah, 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 Yahweh. Yah barak ko Yisrael, hallelujah, Yahweh, hallelujah.